Namaskar, my dear friends. Let us talk about transformer application in LTSpice. So what we will do is, we'll try to design transformer in LTSpice simulation, and we'll try to see what is my input and what is my output. So what happens is, basically you can see here, we have one transformer primary side here, and secondary side we have two couplings, okay, two secondary side winding L2 and L3. And you can see, I'll just show you directly here in the LTSpice. So let us say we have my input voltage, that is 2 volt peak to peak, and my output voltage, first one is going to be twice of that. I'll show you the relation, 100 micro Henry, then 400 micro Henry, that is 1/4, this is going to be 1/2, so that is twice of that. So you can see V output is 4 volt. Similar to that, this will be 1/9, that is square root of that, that is 1/3. So it will be 3 times of that. That is going to be out to be 3 times of that. So it is going to be 6 volt. So we'll design this particular circuit and we'll try to understand how it happens. So let me show you how the application works. So let us say we have the primary inductor here and secondary inductor here. So the relation between primary side number of turns and secondary side number of turns is like this, that L1 by L2 is going to be square of N1 by N2. And similar to that, we are going to find out what is the relation for N1 and N2. You already know that V1 by V2 is going to be equal to N1 by N2. Alright. So if my N2 is twice, then my V2 will be twice. This is how you are going to get your output voltage twice or thrice based on the number of turns. So let us start simulating this particular circuit and try to see how it happens. So what I'll do is, I'll just open LTSpice and remove them all. This is the new circuit that is there with us. Now we are going to design transformer application in this particular session. So what we'll do for that is, we'll take up a voltage source. So it is going to be a voltage source. Now we'll take up inductors. So press L to get one inductor. I'll press Ctrl R to rotate this. Then we'll take up resistors. So one will be like load resistor. One more resistor, I'll take it as a series resistance kind of thing. Alright, so we have almost circuit elements ready. Then we'll put one ground. So let us put ground here and secondary side. Now, as you can see, there are no direct transformer available in LTSpice. So we will try to set these inductors as transformer primary winding and secondary winding. And based on the inductance value, they will be having the number of primary turns and secondary turns. Okay. So what we'll do is, we'll try to find out, you know, like 2 times of output. So basically, if it is 100 microfarad, what will be the value of 2 times 4 output? 400, right? Because 1/4 square root of that is 1/2. So let us say I am going to put out 100 micro Henry, and here that will be 400 micro Henry. Understood. Now one more thing that you can see in the inductor is, we have so dot phase. So dot phase, if I put, then dot will be appearing. Okay. Then you can show this one as well. So dot is appearing. So this is how they are going to do that. Now let us define an input voltage. So I will put input voltage as sinusoidal inputs. So let us say I am going to put sinusoidal inputs with amplitude, let us say 2 volt peak to peak. Frequency, if you want, I can put it like 1 kilohertz. And time delay, let us put 0. You can reduce the frequency to, let's say, 50 hertz as well, but I'll just keep it a standard value, no problem. Now what we can do is, we can quickly wire this circuit. So I'll just put W, I'll press wire to start wiring this. So this is going to get wired up like this. Now this is my secondary side. So secondary side also you can wire it quickly. All right, so our circuit is ready now. What is the other values that are missing is, we have series resistance. So this series resistance I had just put to give a resistance in the line. So I can put it in like 0.1 milliohms. and this load resistance let us keep 100 ohm or 10 ohm. Okay, so 10 ohm is more than enough. So now our aim is to run this circuit. So before running this circuit, we'll go and configure the analysis. So since it is 1 kilohertz, we can, let's say we want to see 5 pulses of that. So 1 millisecond is going to give me 1 pulse, so I'll just run it for 5 millisecond. Okay, and I start saving data from 0 onwards. So this is my transient analysis that is set. Now let's run it. So once we run it, what we see is, let's make it right side. So once we run it, we see this is the voltage output that is coming up 2 volt peak to peak. That is my input voltage. Now if I click here output, this is coming 0, like no output is coming. So what I was expecting is I should be getting 4 volt peak to peak, right? But it is not coming, right? So what we'll do, what is the missing thing? Actually, we have not coupled my primary inductance to the secondary inductance, okay? So there is no coupling effect that is happening, okay? So that command we have to give. So for that, we'll use a SPICE directive to give that command. So what we'll do is we'll press dot to come to the SPICE directive, or otherwise you can go to that this dot T to go to a SPICE directive, okay? So just press dot to come to a SPICE directive. Now use the value K. Then what is the inductance at primary side? L1. Then where we want to couple it? L2. And let's say coupling coefficient, I'll just put it 100%, that is 1. Okay, so this is how we can make it ideal coupling, that is 100% coupling. Before running this, I'll just name these nets. So what I'll do is press N and put it V in. So this is my input and this is going to be my output. Right click it and rename it to, let us say, out 1. Okay, now let us rerun it, and you will see now this is my input voltage and this is my output voltage. So as expected, my output was 2 times. So this is how you can see 4 volt peak to peak. Now let us say I'm going to change this particular coupling coefficient to 0.9. okay, it is not ideal 100%. So what will happen? You can see the output will not be exactly 4 volt. That is not going to be 2 times. It will be lesser than that. Okay, so if you run it, it is going to be lesser than that. All right, so this was all about this particular transformer that was shown in this simulation. Okay, now what we will do is we will try to do one more simulation, like coupling 2-3, you know, like windings. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just take up the secondary winding one more time. So let us press Ctrl C and put this circuit one more time. Let us make out 1 as out 2. Okay, and this one, let us say I want it 3 times. So what will happen? I will have to put 3 times means 3 3s are 9. So 900 microhenry I'll have to put. Okay, so my out 2 is going to be 3 times of input voltage, right? So how we can couple, if you rerun it, what will happen is there is no effect on output voltage. You can see V out 2 is still 0. Alright. So why it is happening? Because L3 is not coupled and it is not going to give any output. Alright. So what we'll do is this input voltage, I'll try to couple it to L3. So for that, you can change this particular command. So right click it and put it here, L1, L2, L3. Alright. And then let us make it ideal. So I'll put it 1. So this is how it is going to be coupled to L3 as well. And as expected, we will be seeing my V out 2 should be 3 times, that is 6 volt. So let us rerun it. So my V input is actually 2 volt. V output 1 is going to be 4 volt peak to peak. And V output 2 is going to be 6 volt peak to peak. Understood? So this is how we have simulated our transformer in LTSpice. You can try out different methodology or, you know, like different techniques as well, by varying the input voltage labels, or, you know, like by varying the inductance values to get different kinds of values. If you want, what is the current flowing through this, that you can very easily find out. So you can see it is around 400 milliamperes maximum, right? Similar to that, it will be having 600 milliamperes maximum. Understood? So, right, guys, thank you.